Arawaki vendors lamenting the closure of Arawaki during the emergency order and the effect it's having on their bottom lines. Prime Minister the Most Honorable Dr. Hubert Minnis announced the closure of the popular venue during a national address back on March 23rd. 3 weeks later, proprietor and owner of Bruno's Seafood and Steak Bar, Bruno Minnis, feels Arawaki vendors should be allowed to operate just as any other restaurant.
Restaurants in this country are open up as if there was never a lockdown, if there's never a shutdown. In the West, in the East, in the North, these restaurants are open. And I think it's unfair for the inner city, and especially the fish fry, not to be open up. We need to eat. We need to make money. Regardless of what the government is going to offer you, you still have to encounter those bills afterwards. So you can be worse off at the end of this than right now. So we're only asking the government to be lenient, and whatever they want us to do to make sure that we can provide for our families and staff, whether it's social distances, which we know that's a fact, we are able to do that.
Owner of Joey's Restaurant and Seafood, Dario Williams, expressed similar sentiments, noting that his staff is bearing most of the brunt of this burden.
I have to do some food assistance with some of my staff, because we have a chat group, and I put in to the group that who all need assistance with food, you know what I mean? And about 70% of the staff tell me they need the assistance. If a plate of food or two plates of food is what I could offer weekly for them, then that's what they could do. That they'll gladly accept that. So it's been difficult for staff, and listen to me, it's a lot of people, even in my area, people calling on me every day for water, simple as water. You understand? So it's kind of a little difficult, man.